beings must surrender to me.
No way, Borful, buddy.
Adventurer, your quest awaits.
Hey folks, Crazy Clamor 80 here again, and we're gonna honor another request. This game is called Rabbit, and it is a 2D versus fighting game created by a company called Aorn, A-O-R-N, and licensed to Electronic Arts in 1997. And I think this was only released in Japan. And this was suggested by YouTube user Dr. Krabs. Okay. But it's got really colorful graphics and decent gameplay. The controls are you have a weak punch, or I think the game calls it like low punch and a high punch and a low kick and a high kick, and you can use a combination of the buttons to awaken your spirit animal. And there are spirit animals for each character, and there are 8 characters, and with the spirit animal you'll see them floating around the fighter. Your attacks can be stronger, and you can have new attacks. And this had a Sega Saturn port that we'll just take a look at later on. Not the gameplay, but the actual cover. But there are 8 different characters, and you will play a mirror match with yourself as well. There is a Wu Ling, who has a rabbit form, and there is Tien Ren, who has a hawk, Igith, who has an ox, Hoen, who has a wolf, Jacko, who has a snake, Yulon, who has a fox, Rex, who has a tiger, and Eddie, who has a wild boar. This has very colorful graphics, pretty decent gameplay. Some kind of cool special moves. I decided to go with Wu Ling. She's short, but she has nice reach with her kick attacks, and some nice special attacks she can pull. In order to use your spirit animal, or the game, I guess, calls it a beast, you have to build up your meter by attacking the opponent, or being attacked, or using special moves. And once the meter reads at least 1, then you can use the beast. And the beast will have a life meter. And when that life meter runs out, and it'll just run out on its own accord, it's timed, then you can't use that animal anymore. But as you beat opponents in the game, you get to use their spirit animal, which is kind of cool. Unfortunately, I don't know how to do that. The game might not be completely correct in MAME. I don't know for sure. There is there was one move by my spirit animal. Wu Ling has a rabbit for a spirit animal. In order to use your spirit animal, once your meter is filled up high enough, you press, I think it's low punch, high punch, and low kick all together. All three buttons. And you will use up one full fill up of the meter where it says 1, 2, or 3, a maximum of 3. You will use up one full number for each animal that you call up. Yeah, you press forward and the low punch, high punch, and weak kick buttons or low kick buttons together to make the to call up the spirit animal. And yeah, I can only seem to call up the rabbit, even though it says I can call up the hawk. And this is Jacko with the snake. The characters seem to have a number of Street Fighter type of moves, like forward, down, and down forward, and a punch button, or down, down, back, back, and a kick button, or down, down, forward, and forward, and a punch button. I like the looks of this game. It's very colorful, and the moves are pretty cool. And it's decent enough. Like I said, I think this was only released in Japan. But there is a Sega Saturn port. I never really played the Sega Saturn, but I've heard it has really, really, really nice nice graphics, and it's really kind of an underappreciated system. I never really had to get the newest system that was hot on the market, and I have certainly not played much past like PlayStation 2. I'm an old school gamer for sure, but there are like I said, very, very much Street Fighter type moves that you can pull off in this game. There is also the ability to deflect an opponent's attack by pressing low punch and low kick at the time that they make the attack. You'll deflect, and then while you're deflecting, you can keep holding down low punch and low kick, and then, like, I think do a half a circle backward to forward, and then release all those buttons for what's called a technical blow. But the opponent never seems to, their attack is just too fast for me to be able to deflect and do all that stuff. But they sure don't have a problem doing it against me. On about the third fight, the game's difficulty seems to really spike. And this gal is kind of tough. That is a cool special move. There are special moves that you can do with the spirit, and with the rabbit spirit, I think you do back, forward, you know, a half circle backwards, forwards, and then back to backwards, and I think high punch. So back, forward, down, forward, down, back, forward, or down, back, and back at high punch. And it makes this spinning ball appear around you, and then you fire your rabbit spirit at them. Pretty cool looking attack. You can chain together combo attacks, and there'll be a special bonus for getting X amount of hits in a row, which started being really a versus fighting a staple with, I think, Super Street Fighter 2. Yeah, I like Wu Ling with her umbrella attacks and her long kicks. Boy, that was close. Yeah, the game gets a lot harder with the third fight. But I am kind of disappointed that I could not get the other animal spirits to work. Anytime I called up a spirit, it was always the rabbit. But we'll see the spirit attacks from the opponents. I mean, from all the animal spirits. Yeah, this guy has really crushing wrestling type of attacks. Makes me think of Makes me think of Zangief from the Street Fighter series. And there's her spirit attack again. Yeah, the opponent gets really good at blocking your attack and the counterattacking, or doing the what was it called? The technical blow. I don't know why the game kind of glitched there. Yeah, crap. Yeah, the game just gets pretty hard at this point. There is a final boss, and his name is Zao Long. Yeah, there's a distinct Chinese or ancient Chinese type of feel to this game. Very, very strange with the spirit animals coming into play. Very strange game. And there's a big spiritual attack which I blocked. I will lose this fight, but damn it, I will lose this fight, but then I will show at least snippets of the rest of the opponents with me having invincibility on. What? Come with me, I'll make you happy. Weird. But yeah, I chose not to continue here, but we'll look at snippets of the other enemies that I'll fight. Sorry, I'm drinking Coke in your ear. Well, Merry Christmas to all of you. Hope you have the happiest of holidays. Hope you were able to hang out with your family or loved ones, even with these COVID times. I was able to spend a little time with my folks, my stepmom and my dad, and both my brothers and one of my brother's kids. Yeah, this is a really strange game. This guy here is, he looks like a, kind of a Frankenstein type of guy. He's got a goofy, wolf, spirit animal. This guy's name is, Hoenn, I think it was. Yeah, he very much makes me think of, Frankenstein. I can't make the I can't make the technical attack or whatever it was called, technical blow, quite work. But the opponents, of course, have no problem making it work. And this is Rex. He's got like Tonfa, and his spirit animal is a tiger. But yeah, you collect all those spirit animals with all the opponents that you beat. But as to how to call up the other ones besides the rabbit, I do not know how to do that. It might work better in the Sega Saturn port than in the MAME version here. I don't know if you and your folks are still doing present exchanges. Let me know in the comments what you got. If you got what you wanted. She's got some strange quotes. And this guy is little Eddie. And he's a little fat guy who has a boar, a wild boar, as a spirit animal. And he can change it to a plane, or use a plane and a, looks like a microphone stand. Weird. This game is really strange, and he's got it like a wrecking ball or something. Yeah, she's got, I think, like charge attacks that she can do with her umbrella. And if she misses or it's blocked, then she's open to a counterattack. But she's got decent range with her kicks for being such a short character. I kind of like her. Hey man, you want to die or what? Yeah, I had never heard of this before. This is a weird one, but if you've got requests, I'll take them now. I might have to sneak in some special videos, or I might do some new 20 from series on classic gaming consoles. But I'll definitely put your request on my list, and at least have a look at it. Not all requests will work in MAME. But I'll let you know if I can't get it to work. But yeah, that was the mirror match. I hate fighting like this. And now we're going to face the boss, Zao Long, and he's like a robot with claws, and he can steal your spirit animals from you. And I think he can use them himself. And he'll have a special attack right there. And there, he stole one of them. But yeah, to activate your spirit animal, you press low punch, high punch, and low kick together. And I think forward. You can press all those buttons when you have the spirit animal out, and it will do an attack on its own. There, I blocked his attempt to take a spirit animal from me. Oh, there, and he got another one. He can just keep taking them from me if you keep letting him. But yeah, by this point, I just put on invincibility, and it helps me get through the rest of the enemies quicker. And I don't know what he changed into there. And here's Wu Ling's ending. I don't know the backstory of this game at all, so I'm afraid I can't really tell you what's going on. But that's Rabbit, created by a company called Aorn, A-O-R-N, and licensed to Electronic Arts in 1997. And like I said, I think this was only released in Japan. Never heard of it, but this was suggested by YouTube user Dr. Krabs. And this had a Sega Saturn port. Very very weird, but certainly playable versus fighting game. Sorry, drinking more Coke in your ear. I've just always loved Coke. But I wish you a very Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays. I hope the new year is kinder to you than 2020 was. And here is the cast responsible for Rabbit. And I don't know if you've ever played the Sega Saturn port. Maybe let me know if it's... if it actually does allow you to switch to the different spirit animals. I keep calling it spirit animal. I think it really is supposed to just be beast. Yeah, the move that you make, low punch, high punch, and low kick together to call up your spirit, or maybe it's forward and low punch, high punch, low kick. That can also be used when you have your spirit out to make an attack. But as you beat more and more opponents, you'll get more and more beasts or spirits. And there's a rabbit, a hawk, an ox, a wolf, a snake, a fox, a tiger, and a wild boar. But that is Rabbit by Aorn, and licensed to Electronic Arts in 1997. Very weird, but very colorful and playable versus fighting game. Well, that was, and this is the cover for Rabbit for the Sega Saturn. Well, I hope you have fantastic holidays, Merry Christmas, and best wishes to you and your loved ones, and a Happy New Year coming up. I thank you for watching Rabbit by Aorn and Electronic Arts in 1997. I will see you later with another video. Y'all take care, everybody. Bye-bye.